Hi, welcome to In the Studio here at Davis Media Access. Today joining me is Kelly Yuan, who is a UC Davis student, who's the student everyone wants to be. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, of course. So the reason I say you are the student that everyone wants to be, or at least the one I want to be, is you are able to balance school and multiple extracurriculars and excel at them. Mm-hmm. So my question for you is, how do you do that?
I think the first thing is I like to kind of budget out my day. So I like to plan out what I'm going to do that day in terms of school and in terms of piano. So if I have like projects going on and music that I'm learning, I like to decide exactly what chunk of work I'm going to do that day. And the second thing is just being really efficient, because a lot of times I know for me I get distracted, like I will play the piano and be like watching TV or something like that. And I've really learned kind of over the years to just focus on doing one thing at a time. So if I'm playing piano, I'll like focus on just getting it done as quickly as possible without any distraction.
Definitely, that's great. So you play piano, and what's your major at UC Davis?
I'm a computer science major.
Computer science, and what year are you?
I'm a third year, but I'm graduating this year.
Oh, awesome. Yeah. Wait, so you're graduating early too.
Yeah.
So how did that happen?
It just sort of happened. I'm always someone who likes to keep busy, and so I just kind of planned out my schedule to make me busy, but not too busy. And then I just kind of finished everything early. It never really was a plan to come in and graduate early. It just sort of happened.
Wow. So did you take any summer classes, or you just took a lot of units per quarter, or what?
I did take summer classes, but I also just took a lot of units per quarter. That's just kind of how I like to have my schedule. I think if I'm too free, then I feel really unproductive. I feel like I don't get anything done.
Uh-huh. Okay, but too free would, it doesn't seem like even just as a computer science major alone, it seems like there's, the spare time is limited. And mm-hmm. so you also do intramural badminton mm-hmm. as well. And so when did you start that?
I've been playing badminton since high school. Okay. So when I came to college, I just sort of continued playing at the Arc every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, just with friends. That's kind mm-hmm. of like my socializing, my free time, and just a way to get exercise in.
Yeah, so out of all your activities, you would say, is that when your stress relief kind of,
mm-hmm,
in
yeah.
a way, because you have a lot going on? Like, so when you first came to Davis freshman year, was it hard to adjust? Did you start your sports right away? Did you start piano right away? Or did you ease into it?
When I first came to Davis, it wasn't that hard to adjust, I think. In high school, I went to a really rigorous high school, so I was sort of already used to juggling playing badminton in high school and having practice and doing my schoolwork. And I didn't originally start playing piano when I came into Davis. I didn't even know we really had a music department until one of my friends who's in the symphony introduced me to like the music building and showed me that we had practice rooms that everyone can use and that there were teachers giving lessons. And so I think around my sophomore year, my fall quarter of sophomore year, I started taking lessons, and I just completely fell in love with it again and just been playing ever since.
Oh, that's so wonderful. So when did you start playing piano, just like in your life to begin with?
I started playing when I was 6. My parents signed me up just as an extracurricular to have something to do, because music is always, you know, a good thing to learn. And I really didn't like it at all. So I think when I was in 6th grade, they finally let me quit. I was always begging them to let me quit, because, you know, no kid really wants to practice all the time. Mm-hmm. And it's so lonely sometimes because you're by yourself, and I didn't want to do any of it. And then I didn't really play anymore. I never thought I really would come back to it until sophomore year of college. And I started getting involved in the music department and playing in groups and things like that, and just, I really love it.
Wow, and so that's not just a hobby though, you also do competitions, right?
Not usually, just this one, but I would say it's more of like a serious hobby. It is a hobby in that I don't really plan to pursue it as a career, but I definitely do take it seriously, just like kind of taking another class, like I treat it as like another class that I'm mm-hmm. taking.
That's awesome, so tell me about the competition you won.
So the symphony holds a concerto competition every year. It's just to choose a soloist to play as like the solo piece for their last concert of the year. And last year I knew I really wanted to do it, just because as a pianist, we don't usually learn pieces with orchestra. There's so much solo music that we never really get to learn it unless there's a reason. And so I kind of wanted to enter just to give me a reason to learn that type of piece. And just because I thought it would be good to work on something very big, and I never expected anything to come out of it. I never expected to win at all or nothing, but yeah, I still remember, like, on the competition day, I just kind of, like, let it all go and really didn't think about, like, the pressure about winning or anything like that. I just wanted to play that piece that I've worked so hard on over the years, and, like, it just, I don't know, it just happened.
That's so amazing. So how long did you work on the piece? Like, did you work together with the orchestra? How did that work?
So you work with your own teacher. So the way the competition works is everybody has a piano accompanist. You don't play with the orchestra unless you're chosen to play in the concert. So I didn't start working with the orchestra until last week, actually. Up until now, it's just been with my teacher on the second piano. And I started it in October. I think she and I decided that we were going to do the competition last spring quarter, at the end of last spring. And then October, I really started working on the piece, and I've kind of worked on it really hard and then put it aside, and then worked on it really hard and then put it aside. Mm-hmm.
So were you really proud of how it turned out? Did you mess up at all? Or obviously not since you won, right? But I feel like when you're a musician, you kind of, you know, you can notice things that the audience often doesn't notice.
It was actually funny. I actually did mess up. I thought it actually went really bad because I remember my first six notes came out wrong. And I think that was the best thing that could have happened, because after those first six notes came out wrong, in my mind, I was just like, oh, well, you know, it's over. Time to just have fun and really enjoy it. And then the rest of the piece went really well.
Well, that's perfect. It kind of gave you a little deep breath, you know, you were able to enjoy it, which is important, and then you ended up winning, so that's awesome. So what is your favorite part of being able to do everything in college? Like, I know there are a lot of different activities that you can participate in, and you are able to do them all, and I think that the goal is when you're in high school, you're figuring everything out, and so why do you think it's a good thing that you are able to do all of that? Because I know a lot of people tend to focus on their major and they'll join activities related to their major. So why?
I just like the diversity, and it gives you multiple things to kind of cycle between. I know for me, especially badminton, when I have really bad days in the gym, like if I have a couple bad days in a row, it's really stressful. And kind of playing less badminton and focusing more on piano, it kind of relieves that stress a little bit. And just being able to cycle through things, because when you focus on one thing so much, you get so burnt out after a while, and you really start to not love it anymore, and it starts to become a source of stress for you. And just being able to cycle through multiple things kind of helps me not be stressed about anything.
Yeah, so you say your method is to kind of focus on one thing, then put it aside for a while. It seems like that's a theme. Mm-hmm. Why do you do that instead of just working on it all little by little? Do you know?
I think with badminton and piano, and with a lot of things, if you work too hard on it, if you focus too much on one thing, especially something that requires a lot of emotion like piano, it tends to actually get worse. For me, I know if I'm working really hard on a piece and I'm working on it day after day, it tends to actually get worse, and I tend to get burnt out, and I tend to not want to play it anymore and not feel anything for the piece anymore. And so it's good to just set it aside. And also, I find when I don't play badminton for a while, or when I don't play a certain piece for a while, and when I come back to it, it's actually better because I have a fresh outlook, I'm excited to work on it again, things like that.
That's great. So what taught you the self-discipline that comes along with that? What comes along with balancing all of that, you know? Because for me, I think that I swim, and when I swim, it teaches me discipline because I know I have to keep going. Mm-hmm. But were your parents really like, did they influence you to work hard? Was it just kind of how you are? What do you think?
I don't think it was my parents, because now badminton, piano, they're just hobbies. And I think it's not really discipline, but it's just that I really enjoy doing all those things. I think I don't have to force myself to play piano. I rarely have to force myself to play piano or to go to the gym, things like that, just because I enjoy it. And if I find that I'm not enjoying it, then I tend to scale back. I think it's just all in the balance. I don't force myself, oh, I have to play piano every day, you know. If sometimes I'm not feeling it and there's no, like, deadline coming up, then I'll just take, like, a few days off or something. It's just not being so hard on yourself, I think, all the time.
So do you participate in badminton competitions as well, ever?
I do. I play a few tournaments. I play the Davis tournament. Sometimes, it used to be every year, but not so much now. And also, there's a tournament at Berkeley that I play pretty regularly as well, and just some open tournaments like that.
That's great. So your music, tell me a little more about your music, your piano. Do you go to lessons? Is it like, it's not a class, right?
It is a class. I do get units for it.
Oh, okay.
So I have private lessons with my teacher. It's just once a week and it's for an hour and she and I just work on whatever I want to work on. Basically, I kind of tell her what pieces I'm working on and she just helps me. And then aside from that, I also have rehearsals with other people. I like playing chamber music in groups, playing as an accompanist for people. So during the week, I'll have some rehearsals like scattered throughout. And also some of the UC Davis ensembles. So I used to be in like jazz ensemble and I'm still in symphony right now. And so we rehearse set number of days per week and those are classes.
That's great. So career-wise, you probably want to pursue something regarding your major, right? Mm-hmm. Even though you love your piano so much. So how do you plan on keeping piano a part of your life even when you don't have those lessons as motivation?
So I'm still planning to take lessons when I graduate. I've already talked to a teacher and she said she has extra room for students in the Bay Area where I live. And I definitely wouldn't be spending so much time on it because I'm not really sure with work and everything. Sometimes life gets in the way, but I definitely plan to continue learning new music to see where I can go with my music and just keeping it as a hobby. I think even if I don't have lessons as motivation, but just like playing for fun is great sometimes too.
Definitely. You seem to love it a lot. That's so mm-hmm. awesome. So 3 years you've graduated and mm-hmm. you also took these music units. Did those count for your major at all?
Yes, they counted. I used them to fulfill all my GEs.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's so awesome. I can't believe you were able to do all that. I'm so impressed with you and everything that you've accomplished. So
Thank you. Congratulations.
Is there anything, if you could give, because I'm a high school senior right now, if you could give advice to high school seniors who are about to go to college and they want to pursue everything, what's your advice?
My advice is to just take care of yourself first. I know so many people in college, they feel so much stress all the time. They feel like, you know, they have all these deadlines and things like that. They feel like they force themselves to do things. And I think the most important part is if you don't really enjoy it, then kind of step back and look at whether it's worth forcing yourself to do things. Like obviously for school, sometimes not everyone wants to study and you just have to kind of suck it up and do it. But for other things like hobbies, you can't really let it get you down. Like hobbies should be a source of fun. I think just really looking at everything as a whole and just balancing everything as a whole and making sure that you're happy with everything that you're doing.
That's so awesome. Have you ever had to, you know, take a step back and realize you weren't happy doing a hobby or anything?
Yeah, so badminton, I actually, it's an off and on thing. Sometimes I'm really unhappy. There's a lot of drama that happens and it's kind of like a very precise sport. So you have a lot of really bad days where your timing's just really off and you don't know what's wrong, you don't know how to fix it, things like that, or you're not as strong as you used to be, something like that. And so I think right after high school, I realized that badminton was just really a source of negativity. Like I was really stressed about it. Like, oh, am I gonna have a bad day at the gym today? Like what's going on? All this drama between partners because I'm a doubles player. Mm-hmm. So there's always like drama between like your partners and things like that. And so I took a while off and then I came back to it. And now I just really like play it for fun. I play tournaments, but I go into tournaments with the idea that, okay, I'm just going to play for fun. It doesn't matter like what happens because you can get so caught up with winning mm-hmm. all the time with badminton and piano and with your major is so competitive.
But sometimes that can lead you to winning compared to a competition.
That's true.
So what I've learned from this is you need to take a step back and breathe and just mm-hmm. enjoy everything. And mm-hmm. success will come if it's right.
You know?
Just like, you know, I've seen with you. Mm-hmm. So thank you so much for sharing how you balance all these activities. I will definitely take it with me.
Thank you for having me.
A lot of the viewers will take it with them. So thank you so much for joining us today on Davis Media Access. If you want to watch more videos, you can go to dctv.davismedia.org or find us on YouTube.